fire rips through an Independence apartment complex this morning. Take a look at the view from News Chopper 9 at daybreak. Firefighters could see the flames from nearly a mile away as they left their fire station to respond to the Independence Ridge complex. The building's residents were sleeping, but they were awakened by a nurse driving by on her way to work. Peggy Bright is live now with her amazing story. Peggy?
Kelly, Kathy Moore could see the flames leaping into the air as she approached this scene, but what she didn't see were the telltale flashing lights of emergency vehicles. So she called 911 and jumped into action.
Ran down to the apartment complex and ran upstairs and started beating on doors and saying, there's fire, get out.
It was just before 5 this morning. One of the people on the other side of the knock was Kim Whistler.
Yelling that there's a fire. And I got my son up and I said, we need to get out of here. I started smelling smoke.
Kim was able to grab her cats because of the warning. Today, firefighters helped Kim and the 42 others left homeless by the fire salvage more of their belongings.
I'm hoping I'll have at least half, you know, everything I ever worked for sitting in there.
Investigators believe the fire started in a pipe chase between the first and second floors, then raced up to the roof and quickly spread. When Kathy saw the flames, she thought back to this Independence fire 6 years ago and the loved ones she lost.
I had two nephews die in a fire, and I actually was thinking, nobody needs to die in this fire, so I was just trying to get everybody out.
Kathy stayed around long enough to make sure residents were safe. She even helped them move their cars out of the fire truck's way. Then she went on to work at Center Point Hospital.
It worked out pretty good. I know they lost a lot of things over there, and I'm sorry that happened, but at least I got out alive.
And residents are grateful to her.
Things could have turned out a lot differently than they did.
Now, residents are concerned that their smoke detectors did not appear to be going off at all this morning, but the fire chief tells us that that could be because most of the smoke was contained in the interior of the walls. We're live in Independence. Kelly, back to you.
Peggy, do you think Kathy sees herself as a hero?
Not at all. She is extremely humble about the actions that she took this morning. She's just happy that she was able to help at all.
Sure. I'm sure a lot of other folks do see her as a hero, though. Thank you, Peggy. The Red Cross is helping residents with money for temporary housing, food, and clothing. Some of them will be moving into vacant apartments in that same complex. And viewers like you helped bring us some of the first pictures of that fire. You can see the flames roaring in this shot taken early this morning. Remember, when you see news happening, send us your photos. Just go to KMBC.com and click on You Local.